So please put your hands together for the wonderful Pete Donahue. Woo!
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I haven't been here for the last couple of rounds, but it's good to be back. And yes, I'm being sacrificed. And in case you're wondering why I wear sunglasses when I recite my poetry, it's simply because I have no eyes. But don't worry too much about that, because I've learned to deal with it over the years. This is a brand new poem. It's not going to fit into 3 minutes, but I'll read it faster than I would normally to leave room for our wonderful slammers. Let's get straight into it. Actually, I'll just say, it interests me the things that inspire a poem. And who would have thought a worn washer could? But it did, and here it is. The Resonator. This poem is not about a Delta blues guitar. The Resonator is a well-worn washer inhabiting the bore-o-fix valve that clings to my copper piping, rising up to my first floor toilet. I have no other toilets. So when we flush, the house becomes alive with whale song, ridiculously loud, detectable from the garden, available to the neighbours, whether they like it or not. It could be confused with a trumpet or trombone, a combination of the two perhaps, a new jazz instrument. What was once a system of mercy has now become the music of hell. The plumber we use to service our boiler is a jazzy American, and his name is Rod. This is no joke. His parents were soothsayers, so named him appropriately. He has a giant screwdriver. And fiddled with his ball-o-fix valve, twisting some damn screw with amphetamine enthusiasm, like he was dislodging earwax from Jack Kerouac's brain. It made a slight difference, took the edge off maybe, but after he left, the resonance increased. It's a relatively simple matter to replace the offending washer, although it involves a stopcock maneuver, familiar to devout Catholics, and a little draining of the system, like bloodletting without pain. But let's not get too vampiric about this. And to tell you the truth, I simply can't be asked. Despite the infuriation of my immediate family, I quite like the idea of a novelty toilet flush. It may even be marketable, with people paying good money for a sanitary ware embellishment to brighten up their lives. I need to discuss this with Rob, the aptly named plumber. This could be a partnership made in copper pipe heaven, a water pressure relief to those post-Brexit blues. I didn't believe in the gospel of new business opportunities and the exponential expansion of lucrative markets. Maybe that President Trump will wake up and smell the carefree and rescue the Rust Belt in a manufacturing frenzy of pre-worn ball-o-fix washers to adorn the White House washrooms. We could even name it the Trump Resonator, a post-flush fart you know you want to hear. But enough of this tomfoolery. And back to personal domestics, like my own resonating toilet pipe. Oh, the fun to be had with this new innovation. If you turn on the cold tap, set the basin awash at exactly the right flow, there's a volume decrease to a more reasonable sound level. It's a useful adjustment when considering sleepyheads or early morning migraine casualties. get that flow wrong, however, and you're in trouble deep. The whales shout louder, decrying global warming, which of course doesn't really exist. In the sound chambers of the Trump resonator, however, mess around a bit like we all like to do, and you can find notes, wander through sharps and flats, tickle endless scales, irritate Keithley riffs, aspire to Clapton licks. You can twist those taps above that chipped ceramic basin, hot and cold together, with deep felt rhythm, like an oriental plate spinner, commandeering the decks at around 140 beats per minute. Then here come cool beats, mirroring the sounds from the room next door, where our resident grind producer, Fruity Loops tracks for download and vinyl, cutting the edge, slicing his future, with microphone pause for the perfect sample of the Resonator. Thank you very much.